अखाड़ी वेलकम बैक, विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम द आईसीएलएस सेशन इंशाल्लाह। सो हियर आई कैन सी दिस, आई मेड द टीसीपी यूडीपी ऑन द डाउनवर्ड्स व्हिच यू कैन सी दैट ऑन द एप्लीकेशन लेयर। इफ यू आर रनिंग वाया एफटीपी टेलनेट एसएमटीपी इट विल फ्लो वाया टीसीपी and there are few other which you will go via UDP, but it is mandatory. Whichever that you created on application layer, it has to go via either TCP or UDP. There is no other way to move on. Then we have network layer, let's say layer 3, which is a network layer. There are few equipments located in the OSI layer. Example, let's say you have a protocol on the upper layer which is called port number. This is application layer. Either you can say port number or you can say protocol, anyone. So in the TCP, let's say when you send the data, you need a data. Then you have layer 4, you have a layer 3, you have a layer 2. The data which is coming from layer 7 to layer 4, from the layer 4 you can say port number, because the layer 7 information will be binded into layer 4, port number. Layer 3 we call it as an IP. Layer 2, we call it as a MAC address. Then again, every transactions required source plus destination. The source means from, destination means to. So when you say port number, source port and destination port, sender info and receiver info. Layer 3, source IP, destination IP. Layer 2, source MAC and destination MAC. Example, if you're sending via HTTP, your source port number is 80 and your destination port is respect to the destination receiver. Source IP, destination IP, and source MAC, destination MAC. This is the minimum info that you need to send your data. When I say equipment, device, any device who take decision based on IP called layer 3 device. Example, router. Any device who take decision based on IP called layer 3 device, example router or layer 3 switch. We will know layer 3 switch later. What is that? Then MAC address is a layer 2. Any device who takes a decision based on MAC address is called layer 2 device. Example, switch. Let's say layer 2 called MAC address. The device taking decision based on MAC address is called a switch. Okay. Layer 3 called IP. Generally, router will take a decision based on layer 3. All we call it as layer 3 switch. The switch generally do LAN or local area network. The layer 3 switch or router generally perform WAN, or we call it as switching, or we call it as layer 3, we call it as a routing. So we are concluding the concept. Switching means LAN, or we also called networking. What is networking? Connecting many systems to a central product and sending data between them, called a network, or we call it as a LAN. In technically, we call it as a switching, because the switch perform this function. Before switch arrived, there was a device called bridge before the switch. So when I connect system to a bridge, what we called bridging. Bridge perform bridging, switch perform switching. But both are networking. Initially, repeater came, then hub, then bridge, then switch. This is the evaluation or the upcoming points of any devices. Now we have everywhere switch. We call it as a switching. Routing means sending data between network. What is switching? Sending data within the network. Routing between a network, or we call it as an inter-network. Sending data from one network to another network, inter-network. This is generally we perform with a layer 3 switch or routing. Okay. So in CCNA, we are going to learn switching. We are going to learn switching, which is layer 2 via switch. It's nothing but connect many devices into a switch and loop a lab. Then in CCNA, we also called routing, which is via router, which is layer 3. Okay, this is the major topic, and there are a few other topics we'll talk about later on. Okay, now in Cisco, every switch starts from layer 2, which can do only switching. There are some switches which can also perform routing. We call it as a MLS, or we call it as a core switch. The switch which we have the switch which we have generally in access layer, where our edge device connected, we call it as a layer 2 switch. The switch which will be placed in the core switch, we call it as a layer 3 switch. In Cisco, some models such as 2960, 2950, 9300 called layer 2 switch or access switch. And some model, let's say, example, 3750 or above. Above means 4000, let's say 5000, until 12000 series of switches called layer 3, which can perform as a core switch. We have a two concept, series and model. Let's, for example, 3000 series, 3750 is one of the model within 3000 series. In shortly, 3000, let's say, in 3000 series, 3000 onwards until 3999. These are having some various model within it. Example, 3750, 3650, 3560, some of the 3000 series model. The same way, 9000 series having 9300, 9500 are the models within 3000, within 9003 series. This is the idea behind it. So we'll look into, let's say, as an example. So this is the Cisco Packet Tracer software. You need a Cisco login to login. And on the bottom, that you can see some switches. Example, let's say 3560. You can see 3560 here. Or you can see, let's say 3650, which is the simplest difference. Then this switch, this is 2950. So generally, when you see a symbol like this, or just a two line, which is called layer two switch, which is only perform switching, cannot do perform routing. If you see a switch like this, a symbol, then it is called layer three switch, which can do switching plus routing, both. Okay, so this is an example. Just I'm opening a single click one switch. You can see this is the maximum. You can see a model here. It's mentioned 3560, which is a layer three switch. Above 3000 series, generally we consider as 3000 layer three switch in Cisco. But you can see 9300 is above layer three, but it's generally we consider for access switch. In a short way, to see whether the switch perform routing or only switching, you need to go to see the data sheet of the switch. It will be clearly mentioned routing support or not support. Okay, so on the upcoming session, next session, we will learn about IP address and we can perform a lab. Lab in the sense, we will install few switches and systems to make sure that we perform networking. First, we do a simple general network, then we can go for VLAN from the lab perspective. Any doubt?
So
the last we were discussed about switch models. We have series and model. 3000 is the series, and any number comes within 3000 is the model, like 3516, 3750 kind of numbers. And example 2000 is the series, 2960 is the model. Then layer two switch can perform only switching. Example 2960 switch cannot perform routing. Any switch which is layer three, example 3560 or 3650, can perform switching as well as routing. If you need a core switch in your design, the core switch must be a layer three or routing capable switch. But to perform your access switch, you can use a layer three switch or you can use a layer two switch, anything. Okay. Okay, this is all about today's session. We're talking about the product and the OSA bottom layer. So inshallah, we'll catch you on the upcoming session. Thank you, have a good time from CML Infotech.